valve. Here I'm using the Hunter X2 brand. So I'm just showing here the things that I use to install that. Got some multi-purpose drills, a drill, some irrigation wires, zip ties, level, staples, screwdriver, electrical tape, and the hardware that comes with the irrigation timer. So here I'm just trying to fit the proper size for the wall anchor. Getting that prepped first. Getting that nice and tight. So I'm just picking a point that is best on the wall. And I'm going off of that first hole that I need to make. And getting that drilled in for the first wall anchor. And I'm using the hardware again that came with the set. So as you can see, I'm putting it to that first hole. A little trick here is you want that, as you can see I'm adjusting, just want that screw to be barely get a tight fit, so when you put in that, when you mount it against the wall, you slip it down, it's gonna be nice and snug. So you see here, there's barely any space there. You want it nice and snug on that mounting hole. And then you're gonna take that face off on the bottom here, as I'll show you. And if you pause the video on that last frame, there's two holes on the bottom there that I use. So one on the left, you can't see it in the video, but there's a hole there. I basically just screwed it a little bit so I can make a mark on the wall. And you can see there, you want to make sure that's level as well before you drill those marking points. And here we got a hollow wall, so I have to use those wall anchors. Here I'm using the screwdriver to put it in. I'm sure there's a more professional way to do this, but that's what I had on hand. Shaking out the dust, putting it back on that top screw. Getting that timer level again. Just a nice touch. Now I'm gonna pop in those screws into those wall anchors. Get it nice and snug, nice and tight. Checking it if it's tight. Looks good, looks secure. All right, now we're moving on to the irrigation valve wire. So here I'm using a 4-strand just because it was cheaper than getting the 2-strand wire. Laying it out, making sure I got enough. Always want to buy a few more feet just to make sure you got enough. So we're installing this after the fact, after the project was done here, just because timing-wise, we had to come back and do this. So obviously this is better to do it before the rest of the irrigation's in.
Thank you, thank you.
Yeah,
it's
really nice.
Yep, yep.
Oh, what a big difference.
Hey, how's it going?
Huge
thank you.
Here, I'm just stapling it to the ground. Make sure it's secure. Don't know if this is necessary, but I like to do it just to make sure it's secure. As the mulch degrades, you might want to replace it just to keep it in place. It's pretty secure here. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking those that electrical pliers, barely cutting into that line just because I want to expose the strands of wire that are inside. And you can see I can just easily just pop it off as soon as I make a cut all the way around. So here I decided to use the red strand. So I'm going to use the red strand here, strip it off to expose the copper, and same with the white. So in the trade, white is always for common, for C, you see there. And then that was a little bit tall, a little bit long, so cut it and then bring that underneath the screw there, and then tighten it to make it nice and tight. Put the face back on. And now we're moving on to connecting the valve and the solenoid to the wire. Had a few feet extra here, cut off what I didn't need. And same thing, I'm gonna slowly cut into that irrigation line just enough to squeeze off the outer layer. Remembering that we're using red and white, white being the common, and red being the distinguisher of the valve. So if you had more than one valve, of course, you want to use the different colors for different valves. So there's a lot of ways to do this. I just chose to do it this way just because it's really secure. I found that sometimes when you're installing this, if you don't bend the wire, sometimes it can come loose. Not necessary, just something that I like to do. So you see here, I'm bending that copper wire excess over just to make it really secure and tight. And that way it can't come off. And I'll do the same thing for the red wire. Wrap it around towards the bottom. And then I'm going to take the remaining of that copper, bend it over, then give it a nice cinch. Alright, now these are waterproof connector plugs. You see on the bottom there, there's a little bit of petroleum sticking out. That's what makes it waterproof. You can give it a nice twist and snug, and you'll kind of feel it be snug and tight. Before you put the electrical tape on it and cover it up, you want to test it and make sure it works. Done that many times. Buttoned it all up and secured it, only to realize that the solenoid wasn't working or the wire connections weren't correct. So always check before you close all this up. So there's many ways to do this. I just like to put the tape on the bottom and the electrical tape across these connectors. Some people don't like to do this, but I just like to do it just to give it a little bit of extra protection from the water. And be careful here if you get that petroleum stuff on your hands. It's really hard, and that's why I do these first layers of tape, because I need something for that tape to stick onto. Sometimes that petroleum will come out and the tape won't stick, so it's nice to have something to stick onto. So really simple, I'm just covering the whole thing, making sure it's waterproof. Pretty straightforward. Now I get some zip ties. Just no specific reason, just randomly picking spots to tie the line to, make sure it's all nice and snug. Cutting off the extra. Here I'm just setting the timer. I'll link some other videos that go in depth into how to program this, but for this video I just wanted to show how to install this really quick. So this is where I usually get caught up here with the start times. It does not mean the run times. So start times mean when the irrigation system is going to come on. So usually we like to do it in the morning. So let's say 5:45 a.m. If I was to add a second start time, that would mean the irrigation system turns on another time for another cycle of whatever runtime you put. Runtime, we're looking at, we'll do 20 minutes. Let's do 22 just to be safe. And that's at 100%. And so that's our runtime. And we're gonna go three times a week. So Monday we'll have it on, Tuesday off, Wednesday on, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, like that. Seasonal adjust, so we're in January right now. So 25%, I'm gonna do 25%. Oh, we're just supposed to run. So that is